Hello and welcome, I'm Ben from Digi Technical Support. This video is a demo of how to configure an L2TP IPsec VPN on your Digi Accelerated Linux router. I'm using a Digi TX54 router with firmware version 22.8.33.50, which is the minimum firmware version you need to run this feature. The first step is to go into System Device Configuration. The first configuration step I'll show you is optional. I'm going to go into Firewall, Zones, and add a new zone called L2TP. Add this. Then into Packet Filtering, add a new packet filter, L2TP to Internal. Set the source zone as L2TP and the destination as internal, and add a new rule that is L2TP to external. Source zone, L2TP, destination zone, external. And these two rules will allow traffic coming in on the L2TP VPN to the internal network, which is the LAN, and also traffic coming in on the L2TP network to external, so the traffic can get out, back out to the internet if it needs to. As I say, these two steps are optional, and I'll show you where this is optional later in the config. Moving on, scroll up and into the VPN section. The first step is to configure the IPsec part of the VPN. Give it a name and add. The zone is fine as IPsec. The mode needs to be changed to transport. The authentication we're going to use is pre-shared key. So set up a key, 123456789. Make sure your key is more secure than mine. This is for demo purposes only. Set the local endpoint. I'm going to set this to the wired WAN interface, which is known as WAN1. The ID type, leave it at auto. The remote endpoint, set the host name. Add a new host name, which is any, and this will allow any remote host to connect to this VPN server. The ID type, again, auto. The policy, add a new policy, the local traffic selector. Because this is a transport mode VPN, the type is address, and again we pick the WAN interface that is in use for this VPN. The protocol will be UDP, and the port number will be 1701, and this is for L2TP. Click on remote traffic selector, the remote network will be any, so we'll leave that blank. The protocol set to UDP and the port will be any. Scroll down and go into the IC configuration. Disable initiator mode, so this is only going to be a VPN responder, and then set the proposals. The proposal you set here needs to match the proposal sent by the connecting VPN client. If you don't know the proposal that's going to be sent, you may have to do some research. I know the VPN client I'm going to be connecting with uses TripleDES, SHA-1 and Diffie-Hellman Group 2. Then set the Phase 2 proposal. Again, this needs to match what the connecting client is going to send over in its proposal. That's the IPsec configuration complete. Moving on now to the L2TP. Into the L2TP section, and into the L2TP network servers. Add a new network server. The L2TP access concentrator. We need to say any. The local IP address is the IP address to assign to this router's L2TP interface. I'm going to say 192.168.254.1, and the remote IP address is what's going to be assigned to the VPN client that connects in. Notice these are just IP addresses with no mask applied. So this next part is where the optional firewall step comes in. If you didn't bother creating an optional firewall zone and the two firewall packet filtering rules, you can leave this zone set to internal. If you're following the demo exactly and you've created a new zone called L2TP and set up extra firewall rules for greater control of the L2TP traffic, you can now set this zone to L2TP. The authentication method needs to match the authentication type supported by the connecting client. My client is going to try and use MSChap v2. Pop in the username and password that is required to authenticate the client. My L2TP user for the username. My L2TP pass for the password. The custom PPP configuration is a section where you can add extra PPPD commands. For normal usage, the extra commands shouldn't be needed. The options should be applied in the configuration box separated by spaces. And that's the L2TP IPsec configuration complete. You now need to configure your VPN client to connect to this router. On Windows, I'm going to be using the built-in L2TP IPsec VPN client. Give it a name, server name or IP address. Now this is the public IP address on the WAN interface of the Digi router. Because this is a lab network, I know that my router has the IP address on its WAN interface of 192.168.0.76. The VPN type is L2TP IPsec with pre-shared key. The pre-shared key, 123.456.789. Just make sure it's been typed in correctly. We're going to be using username and password authentication. The username was my L2TP user and the password my L2TP pass. Save that and then click on connect. Verifying, completing. Connected. Doing a root print and scrolling up, I can see here that the new VPN is the primary default route. I've got access to the internet. And just to prove it's going through the VPN, you can see there the trace route. The first hop, 192.168.254.1. And then the packet routes through the internal network out onto the internet. And that's the end of the demo. For more information on this or any other feature of your Digi router, please see the documentation pages at digi.com/support.